Last time on Spider-Gwen, right here at Comicstorian. In this universe, Spider-Gwen is the Spider-Person of her world. In this world, Peter Parker created the lizard mutagen, which turned him into the lizard, and Spider-Gwen needed to battle against him to save her school and her own life, and she inadvertently watched him die. Everyone assumed that Spider-Gwen had actually killed Peter Parker, even though she didn't, including her best friend, Harry Osborn, who found a way to get his hands on the lizard mutagen and decided to fight against Spider-Gwen to avenge his friend who he thought that Spider-Gwen had killed. During all of these earlier adventures, Spider-Gwen ended up losing her powers. And she discovered that the Kingpin was actually a character known as Matt Murdock. And on top of all of that, her father ended up in prison for aiding and abetting the known criminal Spider-Gwen. To get her father out of prison, Gwen Stacy has agreed to work for the Kingpin, even without her powers. And in our last video, Gwen Stacy was sent to capture Harry Osborn so that they could use his lizard mutagen with their isotopes and create the symbiote Venom. Everyone chased down Gwen Stacy and Harry Osborn until Gwen decided to use those isotopes over her friend's body and draw Venom out of him, to free him from becoming a monster like their friend Peter. Not only was Venom created in the last moments of our previous video though, Gwen's father George was attacked while in prison and his condition is critical. This is the Comicstorian channel where we take some of your favorite superheroes, find the storylines and the lore behind them, and we give you the nitty gritty. We break down the storylines into audio dramas, we give you background history on your favorite heroes and villains, and we deep dive the more interesting questions. And today, we're going to bring you the first part of Gwenom. Gwen Stacy stands over Harry Osborn's body, where she waits for Venom to bond with her, thinking that this will just be another thing she has to deal with, a symbiote sharing her body. However, the symbiote doesn't go for her, and instead it lunges straight for Logan. Logan pops his claws, telling Shadowcat, "Get behind me!" And as she swings, the black goo covers his face. Logan falls to his knees, screaming in pain as the Venom symbiote bonds. But because of Logan's healing factor, he doesn't die. As the screaming stops, Shadowcat asks him if he's okay, and Logan stands back up, wearing a black suit of armor, stating, "We're feeling better than ever before!" The police begin to surround everyone, and Gwen shouts to them all to get back. "There's something wrong!" But Logan laughs, "Nothing's wrong!" And he runs through slicing up the officers. Meanwhile, back in Manhattan, D.A. Franklin Nelson stands outside the ICU on the phone telling Matt Murdock that he just wanted George Stacy silenced, not dead. Matt tells him that George Stacy isn't dead, at least not yet. A coma is Club Med compared to what was waiting us if he had taken the stand. As Foggy Nelson goes on, DeWolf looks back at him and says that he thinks that she knows. Matt tells him to just make sure that the captain's room is heavily guarded. After all, Spider-Woman is still on the loose, and she betrayed us. As Matt hangs up, he looks down at the hand ninjas that Gwen stopped, and then notices her bag. He reaches down, picking up her portal watch, telling himself, my, Gwen would lose her head if it wasn't attached. Back out on the streets, Shadowcat grabs onto Logan, telling him that he needs to stop, but Logan laughs.
Sorry, party's just getting started.
He pushes the Sonic Disruptor, stunning himself, Shadowcat, and Venom. He drops the device and Gwen quickly grabs it, but also she sees Venom beginning to separate from Logan. Shadowcat calls out to her not to turn it off, but Gwen hits the button, stopping it, stating, "No, we can't kill him. They would both die if I didn't turn off the stun." Venom begins to bond back with Logan, but as he runs away, Gwen says, "Don't worry, I got an idea." A short distance away, Logan jumps through the alleyway and Gwen swings overhead with Shadowcat as Shadowcat is yelling for him to stop. Gwen releases her webs and jumps off a trolley, telling Shadowcat to just stick to the plan. The two tackle onto Logan and Shadowcat uses her powers to phase into Logan and pull him out of Venom. But as the three land, Gwen says that can't be good. That was way too easy. Either way, we need to get out of here. Shadowcat helps Logan up and the two begin running, with Gwen holding out the Sonic Disruptor, telling them both, "Here goes nothing." She pushes the button and the sonic waves then hit Venom, sending Venom into a frenzy. Gwen backs up to a wall, mumbling to herself, "Please work, please work, please work." And Venom latches himself onto Gwen and it begins to take her over. But during this, Matt Murdock holds out her phone, telling himself, "She really blew it this time. She has one chance to be whole and in control again. I could have told her the sound was our first weapon against that creature." But just before Venom fully covers Gwen, she webs her phone out of Matt's hand and she begins to play music. And a few seconds later, the now fully bonded Gwen falls to the ground, with Matt asking how does she feel. Gwen gets up and charges at him, grabbing him by the neck, letting the suit fade, telling him, "I feel great." He struggles to breathe, asking how is she resisting, and Gwen points to her earbuds, telling him, "Sound." When it comes to music, turns out me and Venom like the same kind of beats. And Matt lets out a laugh, telling her, "Ha ha, well done, triumphant at last. But this isn't a game of checkers, it's a game of chess. You really should have kept a better eye on your little portal watch. Have you learned nothing? Being so distracted can make you lose sight of what really matters." The portal then begins to open up, and Gwen sees her father in the hospital. She slams Matt onto the ground, asking, "What did you do?" And Matt tells her, "It wasn't me. You're the one who left." Dropping her phone, calling to George, and as she picks up his hand, he doesn't respond. Seconds later, officers kick in the door, telling Gwen to freeze, but Gwen turns back to them, telling them, "You were supposed to protect him," and she begins to lash out, knocking one of the officers down, and as the second one fires his gun, he hits Gwen in the armor. She walks over, covering the gun, and then smacks it down, breaking the officer's wrist. She then grabs DeWolf by the throat, and DeWolf says, "No, don't do this! I can't help you like this!" And as Gwen loosens her grip, she tosses DeWolf to the ground, telling her, "You're right. You can't help him. And when I find whoever did this, we will hurt them." Later in Hell's Kitchen, Gwen storms into a bar, telling them, "I'm only going to ask once, Fancy Dan. Where is he? Where is the Rhino?" Dan laughs, telling her, "Give me a friggin' break. Alexi fights Spider-Woman once and now thinks he's some kind of supervillain?" Gwen slams her fist down, telling them, "Now!" And Dan sighs, "You don't want to leave? Fine." Montana throws his rope around Gwen, and Gwen uses it to throw him across the bar. Ox runs at her and swings, but Gwen catches it and begins to crush his hand. "Okay, let's try it your way." She begins to beat into the men, feeling Venom slowly taking over, so she runs over to the jukebox, putting a quarter in to play music. As she falls to her knees, breathing heavily, she lets the music bring her back. And after a little while, Gwen takes Dan to the roof, hanging him over the street with webbing as he screams to let him go. He shouts that he doesn't know anything, but as Gwen plucks the webbing, she says that she thought he was the big man. Won't making an example of him make his friends a bit more cooperative? Dan screams at her to wait, but before she can cut the last strand, there's an explosion of smoke, and Otomo calls out to her. Gwen looks back, and Otomo throws a matchbook of a bar called Jack's at her, telling her that he brings word from Master Murdoch. Alexi is no longer under their protection. If it's the Rhino that she seeks, she'll find him there. Gwen asks, "Are you kidding? This has to be a joke. Do you think I'm stupid?" But watching this conversation from another rooftop is a scruffy Frank Castle. Outside of the police station, an officer picks up his phone and he says that he understands. The Jack's Bar. "You can count on us, Mr. Murdoch." The officer grabs his shotgun and tells the other, "All right, boys, suit up. Spider-Woman is on her way." Over at the bar, Rhino lays his head on it and Matt asks, "Would you like another round?" But as he goes on to answer, Gwen shouts for him, telling him, "You owe me in blood!" Matt gets up from his stool, stating, "Oh, would you look at that? On my cue. Good luck, Alexi." Gwen shouts to Matt, "You aren't going anywhere!" And as Matt opens up a portal, he asks, "Are you really going to waste this chance to come after me? Use that power to punish the man who actually hurt your father." Gwen looks back at Rhino, and as he swings, she ducks, swiping her claws, cutting into Rhino's chest. She then creates a thin string of webbing, wrapping it around the Rhino's neck when tear gas is shot in from outside. The officers storm in and Gwen says, "I knew this was a setup!" And one officer tells another, "Keep those sonic batons ready and keep the camera going." Gwen thinks to herself, "Is this what you really have? You want proof? Well, we don't care!" But before the officers can move in, a large figure rushes through, grabbing Gwen, snapping her back to reality. She gets up coughing and sees Frank Castle. And as she asks what he's doing here, he tells her to stand down. "This battle isn't with you. This time it's war." Frank then aims his repulsor cannon at Rhino and fires. Venom takes back over and Gwen shouts, "Ours! Rhino was ours!" And she lets out a horrifying scream. Later, Gwen sits alone on a building, stating that Rhino's dead. He has to be. She didn't mean to kill him. She didn't get to kill him. But she wanted to more than anything that she's ever wanted. She has to get this thing out of her. And that is the cliffhanger. We are going to leave you with our multi-parter Gwenom storyline. This takes place over the course of volumes 5 and 6. And I'm trying to keep them relatively short so that we can bring you the final conclusion to the original Spider-Gwen storyline with this Gwenom plot. Gwen is now taken over by Venom. She's chasing Matt Murdock, who has her portal watch and is kind of getting away from her all over the place. And on top of all of that, her father is in a coma. Is she going to recover from all of this? Well, time will tell. Or you can subscribe to the channel to get the next chapter of the Spider-Gwen plotline very soon. I hope you guys enjoyed this little tidbit to get you led into the whole Gwenom plot. And if you did, please consider subscribing to the channel and hitting that bell down at the bottom and turning on notifications. It's the best way to find out when we continue this plot. It'll most likely be within the next week. I hope you guys did enjoy, and don't forget to please follow me on Twitter, @ComicStorian. We can chat about whatever you want, be it comic books, video games, or movies, whatever is more convenient for you, and I'll see you next time right here.